Following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st Canto, 2nd Chapter, Text Number 20, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on August 23rd, 1972, in Los Angeles.
Translation. Thus established in the mode of goodness, the man rejuvenated by loving service to the Lord gains liberation from material association, mukti, and comes to know scientifically of the personality of Godhead.
So, Bhagavat Tattva Vigyana. Vigyan means science. It is not concoction, speculation. It is a science. Just like mathematics is a science. 2 + 2 = 4. You cannot make 2 + 2 = 5 according to your whims. No. Anywhere you go, it doesn't matter. Because it is science, so either in America or in India or in England, everyone will accept 2 + 2 = 4. That is science. Science is true everywhere. Not that I can imagine my God according to my whims. You can imagine your God. That is going on. Now, how you can imagine? There is no question of imagining. This Bhagavat Tattva Vijnanam, this truth, this science, can be understood by a person who is Mukta Sangha. Mukta Sangha. Meaning free from material association. He can understand. Mukta Sangha Sajayata. And the condition is evam prasanna manaso. When you are enlightened, engladdened, because so long we are in the jurisdiction of ignorance and passion, there cannot be any jubilant. There cannot be any enlightenment. Therefore you have to come to the platform of goodness. As it is stated in the previous, tada rajastamo bhava kamalubhadayastraji cheta etairanavidyam. Cheta, everything is working within the heart. The whole thing, heart is the central point of this body. So, when the heart is not punctured by the rajagun and tamagun, and you become situated on the modes of goodness, then you become jubilant. Jubilant means he can understand at that time that why these people are working so hard, like cats and dogs. The human life is meant for understanding what is God. Pathata Brahma Jigyasa. This life is meant for simply understanding what is God. The animal life, they cannot understand. That life is different. But the human life is developed. Consciousness is developed. He can understand. This is called goodness. Tasyaiva heta prajateta kovida. How one becomes intelligent? He can study. When he is on the platform of goodness, he can study the nature. So why I shall work so hard for getting my material necessities? This is being supplied by nature. The birds and beasts, they are getting their food, they are getting their mates, they are being protected in their own way, they have got a sleeping nest apartment. So even an animal, even a small ant, we sit down in the garden, we see, even the small ant, it has got family, it has got home, it has got eating, everything is there. From ant to the elephant, who is supplying? They have no business. They do not do any business. They have no profession. But they are getting their necessity supply. Therefore, intelligent person, this is, goodness means intelligence, prakash. Ignorance means darkness. In darkness we cannot see what is what. So, goodness means light. Anyone can see that there are 8,400,000 species of life or forms of life. They are getting their food, they are getting their shelter, they are satisfying their sex, they are also defending without any extra endeavor. By nature they are doing their own way. So why human being, so-called civilized human being, is so much harassed for these four things? We have got better intelligence, we shall be rather more comfortable without struggling for existence than the animals. But our struggle for existence is greater than their struggle of existence. What is this civilization? This is not civilization. Everyone wants peaceful, calm life. Even those who are struggling so hard, big business magnate, still at the weekend they find out some secluded place, nice place without trouble. That is the nature. That human nature should be like that. Then why should we work so hard simply for eating, sleeping, mating? This is a wrong type of civilization. But at the modern age, the human society is so made that one has to work like ass whole day and night simply for satisfying these four necessities of life. That is also not guaranteed. We thought that in your country, when I was in India, I was contemplating to coming to your country, I thought that America is very rich, there is no problem for eating, sleeping, mating. Actually there is need, there is no problem. But the civilization is so mad that there is no shelter, they are lying down on the park, on the street. Why? There is no necessity, but they have created such civilization that a certain section of people are voluntarily, are being obliged, lying down on the street, on the path, no dress, no food, no fixed star sex life, everything is topsy-turvy. Everything is topsy-turvy. But this is not civilization. This is not civilization. Then how they can understand God? Their mind is always disturbed and full of anxiety. So first of all, you have to come to the state of tranquility. Prasanna manasu. Evam prasanna manasu. Prasanna manasu is always jubilant. That can be achieved by this process, Bhagavad Bhakti Yogata, by devotional service, no, by no other process. Evam prasanna manasu Bhagavad Bhakti Yogata. One can be jubilant only by practicing Bhagavad Bhakti Yoga. There are many other yoga systems, Karma Yoga, Jnana Yoga, Dhyana Yoga, Hatha Yoga, everything you endeavor for spiritual enlightenment, that is called yoga. So there are different types of yoga. But real yoga is Bhagavad Gita, devotional. Therefore, in the Bhagavad Gita, it is said, yoginamapi sarvesam, of all the yogis, there are different types of yoga system and different types of yogis also. But Krishna says, of all the yogis, yoginamapi sarvesam, madgata antaratmana sadhyaman bhajati jomang, Sami Jukta Tamavamata. That yogi who is devotee and always thinking of me or thinking of Krishna within the heart. Yoginam api sarvesam madgata antaratmana sadhyavan faithful bhajate. This is bhajan. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Krishna. So, he is first class yogi. Who is chanting Hare Krishna mantra and thinking of Krishna within his heart, first class yogi. That is Bhagavad Bhakti Yoga. And if he does it nicely according to the rules and regulations, in the beginning, then he becomes prasanna manasa, prasanna manasa, enlightened. There is no more any lamentation or hankering. This is the sign. Evam prasanna manaso bhagavata bhakti yogata. Then you can understand what is God. God is not so cheap. Come on, I shall show you God. You haven't got to follow any rules and regulations. People want to be cheated, therefore there are so many cheaters. They take advantage of it because they want everything very cheap. That is not possible. Oh. This is the stage. Prasanna manasa. Oh. Then you can understand what is God. Bhagavat tattva, because it is a science. Eh? If somebody says, come on, I shall teach you the science of chemistry within a second, give me some money. Is it possible? Huh? If somebody says, I shall teach you mathematics, come on, give me some money. So why these rascals are misled? It is a science. It is not sentiment, it is science. In other words, understanding of the Supreme Personality of Godhead without reference to these scientific books, Vedic literature, it is simply disturbing, simply rascaldom. Creating disturbance only, cheating some people. They are cheated, they do not get anything, create some disturbance. That is the instruction of Rupa Goswami. Shruti Sriti Puranadi Pancharatriki Vidhing Vina Oikantiki Harer Bhakti Utpata Eva Kalpata. Utpat. Utpat means disturbance. So many rascals, without reference to the Vedic literature, reveal scriptures. Shruti, Sriti, these are Vedic literatures. Shruti, Sriti, Puran, Panchratri ki Vidhi. Without reference to all these books, if anyone possesses himself that he has understood God and devotional service, it is simply disturbance, creating disturbance. That's all. Shruti, Sriti, Puranadi, because it is a science. How you can manufacture it? It is not that thing. Therefore, any religion without scientific understanding, through philosophy, it is simply sentiment. It is not religion. And philosophy without religious understanding is mental speculation. That is also useless. Philosophy which does not search ultimately what is true, what is God, that philosophy is mental speculation. And the knowledge of God without philosophy is simply sentiment. This will be combined. To understand God, our relationship with God, our duty, everything should be understood scientifically. Bhagavat tattva vijnanam, therefore this word has been used, vijnanam. Vishesha jnanam. Jnanam, ordinary knowledge. And B, when this word is added, B means vishesha, particular, for practical application. This vijnanam. So this vijnanam, this science can be understood by mukta sangha, who is freed from the lower modes of material nature, especially tamagun and rajagun. Do not be fooled by so many rascals that Bhagavat Tattva Vijnanam, the science of God, understanding is so cheap that anyone can give you by simply one day's association with some rascal. You see? This is not supposed. Yes, it has to be studied, it has to be practiced, it has to be realized. So this vijnanam is being stated in the Śrīmad-Bhāgavatam. Therefore, in the beginning, in the Śrīmad-Bhāgavatam, dharma projita koitabhattha. All rascaldom going on under the name of religion, cheating religion, they are completely kicked out from Śrīmad-Bhāgavatam. Simply on scientific understanding, we are presenting what is Krishna consciousness. Not for sentimentals. It is the purpose.
Perfection of life. Mostly they are conducted by the modes of passion and ignorance, and thus they are engaged always in lust, desire, hankerings, ignorance, and sleep. Out of many such man-like animals, there is actually a
man-like animals. They saw with two hands, two legs, but actually they're animals. Four-legged. Two legs have been transformed into two hands.
Out of many such man-like animals, there is actually a man who knows the responsibility of human life and thus tries to make life perfect by following the prescribed duties. And out of many, and out of such many thousands of persons who have thus attained success in human life, one may know scientifically about the personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna.
Yeah. So it is not so easy to understand Sri Krishna. Manasanam sahasreshu kastijyatati siddhaya jatatamapi siddhyanam. Those have endeavored for perfection of life. Out of many such persons, one can hardly understand Krishna. It is not so easy. But it is by Krishna's grace. Krishna, being very compassionate with these fallen souls of this age, he appeared as Lord Chaitanya and distributed Krishna. That is his prerogative, that is his right. If Krishna wants to distribute himself freely, that is a different thing. Otherwise, it is not so easy to understand Krishna. Just like to earn $1 million is not so easy. But if you are fortunate, you meet somebody who can distribute $1 million at a time, that is a different thing. Therefore, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was recognized by Rupa Goswami, Namo Mahavadanaya, Krishna Prima Pradayat. My dear Lord, You are the most munificent of all incarnations. The other incarnation, people could not understand. But you are freely distributing yourself. Krishna Chaitanya Namani. Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namani. Gaurati Se Namah. Therefore, we have to follow the footsteps of Rupa Goswami, Rupanuga. Then we can understand Lord Chaitanya. And if we get favor of Lord Chaitanya, we can very easily understand Krishna. This is the process.
In the same Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavad Gita 1855, it is also said that scientific knowledge of Sri Krishna is understood only by the process of devotional service or bhakti yoga.
Here also it is confirmed. Bhagavad Bhakti Yoga. It is not said by mystic yoga, by hatha yoga, by jnana yoga, by karma yoga. No. Bhagavad Bhakti Yoga. If you want to understand the science of God, then we have to adopt this devotional service, not by yoga. Otherwise, in Bhagavad it would have been said by karma yogata, by jnana yogata, by hatha yogata, by dhyana yogata. No, it is clearly said Bhagavad Bhakti Yogata. Bhagavad Tattva Vijnanam Mukta Sangasya Jaya. If you are still after jnana-yoga, you cannot understand God. It is clearly said, and the Bhagavad Gita also, it is clearly said, bhaktya mam abhijanati. Simply through devotional service. So if you want to know God, then you have to follow the prescribed rules and regulations of bhakti yoga. It is very simple. It is made very easy, especially in this age. Simply by chanting Hare Krishna mantra, it's so made easy. But we are so unfortunate that we do not take advantage of this. Itadisi tava kripa bhagavan mama ki. Duddhaiva idrisa miha janinanuraga. Like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu laments, my dear Lord, you are so compassionate and merciful upon us that in this age you have descended in your as your name. And one can chant this name without any regulation. Niyamita smaranena kala. Any time, any circumstances, one can chant this Hare Krishna mantra. Krishna has become so liberal. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, itadrisi tava kripa bhagavan mamapi, my dear Lord, although you are so much merciful upon me, still I am so unfortunate. Itadrisi tava kripa bhagavan mamapi duddhaiva idrisha. I am so unfortunate, duddhaiva idrisa miha janina. I could not be attached to chanting of Hare Krishna mantra. I am so unfortunate. You see, the things have been made so easy, actually. But unfortunate class of men, they cannot take to it. Thank you.